GM's LS series of V8 engines is arguably one of the most popular around the world for both modifications as well as engine swaps due to the power and torque that these engines produce, as well as the wide availability of aftermarket performance parts. Here at HPA, we want to produce more course content that's going to be relevant to those of you out there who want to learn how to both tune or build an LS series V8 engine. And we've just taken delivery of this VE Holden Commodore, which runs the L98 engine. If you live in a part of the world which never received the Holden Commodore, or perhaps you've never heard of the L98 engine, don't worry. The L98 engine is essentially identical to the much more common LS2 6-litre V8. The major difference being that it uses the rectangular port L92 cylinder head, which is superior to the LS2's cathedral port head. For those of you in the US market, this car should be fairly recognisable because it was marketed there as the Pontiac G8. The important thing to understand is what we're going to be developing and what we're going to be learning on this L98 engine is still going to be helpful across a wider range of vehicles due to the similarities across the entire LS family of engines. At the moment, the car's completely standard and they are rated to produce 270 kilowatts at the flywheel. While that's not bad, it's not quite enough, so we've got some plans to modify the engine and release just a little bit more power from it. Before we get into that though, we wanted to run the car up on our mainline dyno to find out exactly what it's producing right now at the wheels. As we can see, the results are 209.5 kilowatts at the rear wheels, or if you prefer to work in horsepower, that's 280.9 horsepower. Some of you may be wondering why we haven't registered that manufacturer's specification of 270 kilowatts. Now, the reason for our missing power is that our dyno measures power at the rear wheels, whereas the manufacturer's specification is at the flywheel. Between the flywheel and the rollers on our dyno, we have the automatic transmission, we've also got the rear differential, and finally, we've got some power loss through the contact patch between the tyres and the rollers. So at this stage, we've got somewhere a little bit under a 25% power loss registered by our mainline dyno, which is relatively typical. We've got a couple of stages of modification planned for our L98, and ultimately we will be fitting a cam because this is one of the easiest ways to extract really significant power gains with these engines while staying naturally aspirated. For now though, with our first stage of modifications, we're going to be aiming to maximise airflow in and out of the engine and essentially optimise what GM have given us. We're going to do this by addressing both the intake and the exhaust system. With the exhaust system, we're going to be ditching the entire factory system, including the heavy and restrictive cast iron exhaust manifolds. We'll be replacing these with a set of Xforce stainless 1 7/8 diameter extractors, and then this will be matched to a 3-inch cat-back Xforce exhaust system. So this will allow the engine to breathe. It's also going to give us that nice V8 exhaust note that everyone who owns one of these cars wants. On the intake side of things, we've got the factory restrictive airbox. We're going to be getting rid of all of that and we're going to be fitting a VCM suite over the radiator cold air intake. As its name implies, this takes cold air from the grill directly in front of the radiator, essentially giving us a ram feed of fresh cold air straight into the throttle body. These two relatively simple and common upgrades will improve the airflow through the engine. However, to really make the most of these upgrades, we're also going to need to address the ECU tuning. In this case, we don't need to fit an aftermarket ECU, and one of the really big advantages with the LS V8 is the easy tunability of the factory GM ECU. In order to do this, we're going to be reflashing that factory ECU using the powerful HP Tuners software. All up, we're expecting an improvement of between 30 and 40 kilowatts at the rear wheels, along with a healthy increase in torque. The other aspect with these modifications is that while we are going to be making more power and torque, we also can expect a modest improvement in fuel economy, so sometimes you really can have your cake and eat it too. If you want to see the results once we've finished our stage one upgrades or the rest of the project as it pans out, make sure you're watching our social media channels. And if you've got any questions or anything you'd like to see on the car, let us know in the comments.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.